One of the common questions I get is, how can we add a library like Bootstrap to our application? Now, if you have never worked with Bootstrap before, it's basically a CSS library that gives your applications a modern look and feel. You can learn about Bootstrap by going to getbootstrap.com. Now, in this lecture, let me show you how to add Bootstrap to our Angular application. First, in the terminal, in the list of bundles, look at this bundle. styles.bundle.js. The size of this bundle is only 10 kilobytes because currently we don't have many styles in our application. So 10 kilobytes. Now in VS Code, open up the terminal using Control and Backtick. Use npm to install Bootstrap. So npm install Bootstrap. And we add dash dash save flag here. What this does is that first it downloads Bootstrap and stores it into node modules folder, but the save flag also adds Bootstrap as a dependency in package.json. Let me show you. So first let's execute this command. All right, we got Bootstrap version 3.3.7. Beautiful. Now let's go to package.json. So package.json. In the list of dependencies, look, we have an entry for Bootstrap. And here's the version number, 3.3.7. Now, what is this caret character here? Well, this version consists of three numbers, a major number, a minor number, and a patch number. This caret character means we can use the most recent major version. So we can use version 3.4, 3.5, 3.9. But if there is a newer major version, like version 4 or version 5, you're not going to install that. We can upgrade to the most recent major version, in this case, version 3. Now, what is the benefit of adding an entry in package.json? Well, when we check our application code into a source control management tool like Git, we are not going to check in the node modules folder. So this node modules folder includes lots of libraries, and it takes a fair amount of space on the disk. We don't want to check this into a source control repository. So by listing all the dependencies inside package.json, anyone who checks out this code from a source control repository can simply go to the terminal and type npm install. With this, npm looks at package.json and downloads all the dependencies on this machine. Okay? So now we have installed Bootstrap. Next, we need to import its style sheet into our styles.css. So let's go to styles.css. This is where we add all the global styles for our application. Now here we're going to use the CSS import statement. So @ import. And we add the path to Bootstrap CSS file relative from node modules folder. So we use tilde again. Inside the node modules folder, we have a folder called Bootstrap. Let me show you. So here's the content of node modules. We've got Bootstrap. Now here we have a folder called dist, which stands for distributable. And inside that we have CSS. Now we need to import this bootstrap.css here. So bootstrap/dist/css/bootstrap.css. Save. Now let's go back to our courses component, courses.component.ts. Here in the template, I want to add a Bootstrap button. So button, and I want to give it two classes. One is btn that all buttons have, and btn-primary, which makes our button blue. And let's call this save. Okay, now that I saved the changes, let's go back in the terminal. Look at the size of our styles bundle. It's 159 kilobytes. Previously, it was only 10 kilobytes, but now that we imported Bootstrap, we have a lot more styles. Now let's go to the browser. So this is our Bootstrap button. Now, as you can see, this button is too close to the edge of the screen. So back in styles.css, I want to add a style for the body element. Let's add a 20 pixel padding. Save. Back here, that's much better.